Hey guys, Reckless Gaming here. Welcome to part 2 of LEGO Star Wars, the video game. Last time we escaped the palace, we, rescued the queen, with Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan, and now we're heading towards Coruscant, but, escaping the planet Naboo, we get shot down. Not shot down, but we get shot up by some Trade Federation ships, and, we have to make a pit stop on Tatooine. Because our hyperdrive is damaged. There we go. I wanted to say malfunction for some reason. So yeah, we see here Obi-Wan's trying to repair. Me either. So yeah, Qui-Gon, Padme, Jar Jar, and R2, they head into Mos Espa. And they try to buy a new hyperdrive engine from Watto, but he wants some real money. And little boy Annie, he decides to enter the pod race for Qui-Gon. So that's what we're gonna go ahead and do today. And then we're also gonna do level 5. I'm actually recording this in post. I do the commentary. I'm recording the commentary in post. And I do apologize for, taking forever to get this out. It's just this is my first recording that I did, like the footage that we're watching right now. So I recorded part 2 a way long time ago, back in May, and I didn't want to end up using this footage because the recording just went on for too long, and my commentary wasn't the best in it, so I redid it. And I forgot what happened with my second recording. I just did that one like a week or two ago, and something happened. Like I'm not able to use that. I totally forgot why I'm not using it, but there's a reason. I think my commentary was messed up. Like either I didn't press record on my commentary or something. I remember now. My the recording itself. So it was stuck on the main screen where you choose, continue story or whatever. It was stuck on that screen for the whole recording. So even though I was continuing and playing the game, you couldn't see anything. So that's why I couldn't use that footage. So I'm not restarting this game again. It's so annoying because the next level we're going to be doing after this pod race here, it's a long level. It actually threw me for a loop when I recorded it, and you'll see later there's gonna be a lot of cuts, and it's because it took so long to get to the level. But I think it was also just a me thing, because I needed to make up my mind on how I'm gonna get through this game. Going forward, I'm not gonna be focusing so much on mini kits. We'll just go back for the mini kits at the end. When we finish, the prequel trilogy, we'll go back for the mini kits. That's how we'll do it going forward. But that's why there's going to be a lot of cuts, because it took me so long to get through the next level that we'll be doing. And then, yeah, I kept dying here as well. So, I cut this part down to about 20 minutes. So hopefully you guys stick around. It shouldn't take that long. And then also for the pod race, I'm going to be making sure to get all of these mini kits, so that'll also be a little treat. I might get the True Jedi, but I don't know. And I also, I don't think it's called True Jedi in this game, and I think I figured it out because I got it. If it wasn't during this recording session, it was during the failed one that I can't use, so we'll see. I'm pretty close to getting it right now, though. I think we're on the second lap still, so... But yeah, how about that little boy Annie? How nice of him, right? Offering to enter in the pod race. Apparently, according to him, he's the only LEGO human minifigure that can do it in the galaxy. So it's pretty astonishing, and he's holding his own in the race, I'd say. He only died three or four times. I think. Yeah, we're gonna go into the third lap here. So this race is actually called the Boonta Eve Classic, I believe. And gotta watch out for these rocks. It could just totally mess up your speed because the timer eventually comes. I haven't explained what we're actually doing in this level. You gotta, I intentionally slowed down there to get that, and I think I should do it again here. It took me all three tries to get this. Look how slow I went. Yeah, I think I don't make it in time, obviously. I'm probably gonna, yeah, we cut. We definitely cut right there, so. Yeah, but that's all the mini kits, so we'll definitely see what that builds us at the end of this. That's gonna be pretty sweet. Got the Tusken Raiders here. Yeah, I was dying a lot here, so I cut it out. That's what I said, like, I do apologize. I like to do, like, live commentary, but it's also fine, like, for now. Because every now and then when I get to do these parts, it, like, allows me to, like, just speak freely and update you guys on what's going on. So it's pretty cool. Like I said, I'm kind of, you know, rethinking about how I want to do the whole, like, YouTube schedule thing and everything. I wanted to try to do, you know, certain Let's Plays for July and August, but obviously that's not going to happen anymore. So for July, we're going to just try to finish out Lego Star Wars and Sonic 1. And then in August, I'll be starting a new Let's Play, and I'll just be focusing on that. Probably for, like, the first half of August, because it's not a very long game. And then after that, you know, I'll go from there. So I'm pacing myself better. I should be able to, you know, get things out more consistently. So yeah, we won the pod race, you know, got the money. Also, Qui-Gon bought Anakin, it seems like, because he's on our ship now. No, I'm just joking. I guess he made a bet with Watto to get Anakin free, because Anakin was actually Watto's slave. Awkward. Yeah. So yeah, we got the True Jedi, and that gives us a super kit piece. I don't know what that builds. Never got it. Excuse me. Got all the mini kits, so that's gonna go ahead and give us. What is it? Kaboom! It's Sebulba's pod racer, which is pretty neat. I like it. And then I think I said it in part one, but if I didn't, you can go ahead and look at all these vehicles that you build with the mini kits out in the hub world when you go outside. It's like a little parking garage kind of deal. Anyways, now we're on level 5. This is Retake the Palace. To basically sum up what's going on, we headed back to Coruscant, and Qui-Gon told the council, like, yo, like, there's something with this boy. I think he is the prophesized chosen one type deal, you know? So they were like, well, he's too old. We don't want to train him. And then they're like, and we're dealing with this Naboo crisis, so let's just focus on that later. Meanwhile, the queen of Naboo, she turns out to be Padme right here. What? Who would have known? I wouldn't have, especially not in Lego. Yeah, but anyways, Padme, she loses faith in the Republic, so she calls a vote of no confidence on the Chancellor, which is basically like the president of the galaxy, which means that his term is basically up for grab by somebody else. And then she goes to Naboo and teams up with the Gungans to try to free the planet herself, since everything's not going the way they want. And the Gungans are down, since the leader, Boss Nass, he was like that green frog guy. He was like, wow, humans respect the Gungans, or the Naboo respect the Gungans. Let's team up. So yeah, it's all good and dandy. Now we're gonna attack the palace, and we're gonna try to basically get the Viceroy to sign a treaty to get all this madness to end. So yeah, like I said, this is the level that I'm talking about. This level is actually pretty long when you're playing it by yourself. And like I said before, when I first recorded this, this was really back in May. I wasn't, you know, 100% sure on how I was going to structure this Let's Play. So that's why there's a gang of cuts in this level. So like I said, I do apologize. I try to make it cohesive to where you can understand, like, which direction I'm going and how we're progressing along. But like I said, it was pretty much just a bunch of nonsense. I wasn't in the right headspace when I recorded it. I was kind of wandering and trying to find everything when I should have just been getting it through, because, you know. So yeah, there's a mini kit up there. You can grab that if you want. But like I said, we're going forward after this part, we're just not going to really be worrying about mini kits anymore. There's another one at the very top, but I think you're gonna need a high jumper to get it, because I wasn't able to grab it, so yeah. And then I think we just proceed here with R2 now. No more fooling around in that open first area. But there's still more to come, like I said. This level is so long, I wasn't expecting it. This level is going to be the rest of this part, I believe. And then we'll finish up the Phantom, the Lego Phantom Menace next part. So, yeah. But yeah, so basically... Qui-Gon and then they stopped at Watto's shop, like I said, and that's where they first met Anakin, and Watto doesn't want their Republic credits, so they leave and they're basically like, well shit, what do we do? And Anakin's basically done for the day helping Watto, so he lets him go for the day, and that's when he heads out and he offers them like shelter, because he could tell, I guess, that they're not from there, and he's just so nice, and his mom doesn't really seem to give a shit. Even though you would think that Tatooine is, like, probably not filled with the best characters. Like, the best, you know, kind of people around. You'd think there would be more shady people, but hey, it is what it is. So, yeah, like I said, I was just wandering the palace there, trying to see if there was anything. There wasn't really nothing, so we're just continuing forward. And yeah, I guess, you know, Qui-Gon could feel Anakin's ability in the Force, so he tests him for his midichlorian count, which is basically, like, what causes the Jedi to use the Force, kind of. Like, it allows them to communicate with the wills. Which is hard for me to explain. And yeah, basically Anakin has the most midichlorians that have been recorded up to that point, more than even Master Yoda, which is wild. Which doesn't necessarily mean that he's like more powerful than Yoda, it just means that like he can communicate with those wills better. So it's kind of basically like if trained and if he wanted to, like he could... He could probably ultimately end up with like a deeper like understanding of the Force, or yeah, like maybe a more powerful, you know, be able to use it more powerfully than others. So that's like the significance of like Anakin's midichlorian count. A lot of people kind of were upset by midichlorians, I guess, but I think it kind of makes sense, and I felt like it added to it. But you know, I'm a prequel baby, you could say. So, I guess I have a little bit of bias. Anyways, yeah, you want to make sure to build that bridge and build these stairs. I was wandering around for forever trying to figure out what to do. You want to build those, and then everybody will be able to get up to where we need to go. I'm trying to think about like anything else about like the Phantom Menace that I could do. And I could think off the top, you know what I mean? I like The Phantom Menace, actually, as a movie. I think it's pretty decent and fun. I know everybody's like, oh, boring politics, blah, blah, blah. But I don't know, for me, like, that shit. I don't know. I like it. It's not like, I wouldn't say it's like super, like, next level world building. But, like, I don't know, I feel like it's basic world building for you know, the Star Wars universe, like the political side of it and how it all, you know, kind of works. And maybe George Lucas was trying to do his own kind of social commentary, which is fine. So you feel me? I like the Phantom Menace. I still think if like the prequel trilogy had started from like Episode 2, it probably would have like been executed a little bit better. But I really like the starting point. I like Qui-Gon. I really just like that whole era. Like, I would love to see like more of that era, like leading up to Phantom Menace and like post Phantom Menace era. Like, that would be fun. Yeah, this part again, it was just more me fooling around. You want to Hold on, excuse me. I gotta burp. But yeah, what's it called? You just wanna, yeah, break all these things, use the force on those platforms, and make sure everybody can get up. I think there's like a, there's like a bullshit platforming puzzle over there to the right, and all you get is a, like a blue stud. So, you know, I wasted my time thinking that it was a mini kid up there. Now we're gonna enter this library type section. There's gonna be a bunch of stuff around here that you can distract yourself with. Just go ahead and ignore it all. It was nothing significant. It was just a bunch of studs, I believe. There might be a mini kit or something laying around somewhere, but I don't think I was able to grab it. I would have showed it if I did. Yeah, I like Qui-Gon a lot too. Like, Qui-Gon is the GOAT. I think it's funny how, like, you know, recently everybody's been talking about how, oh, you know, Qui-Gon's the father figure Anakin, you know, needed. And yeah, like, to an extent I agree, but it's like, in a way, I'm like, low-key, I feel like Anakin still would have turned under Qui-Gon. Under Qui-Gon's leadership. If anything, Anakin would have turned, like, probably later down the road under Qui-Gon's mentorship. And he would have been more powerful than what he was when he did turn. But, the way I look at it is just, like, yeah, Qui-Gon would have been a good teacher to him, for sure. But, The Emperor still would have had his machinations in play. Anakin's mother would have always been in danger, no matter what. Like, if the Tuskens didn't grab her, spoilers, for our next Lego, spoilers for our next Lego movie. I don't know why I'm beating this guy up. See, that's what I'm saying? Like, I'm just wasting time. Like, they just don't care, though. They're not gonna get up. Doesn't sting, doesn't cut right through them. He's good. It kind of looks like he's chilling. But anyways. Yeah, Anakin's mom would have always been in danger, which would have always been, like, the key to probably his turning. All it would have taken was the Chancellor to, you know, organize a hit on her. It would have been bad. She was always going to be, you know, a crux for him. So it truly was just too late. So that's what I'm saying. Like, I feel like Anakin still would have turned, if not just later, maybe even earlier, just depending on how things play out. But I don't deny that Qui-Gon would have been a good master to him. And I also don't deny that Qui-Gon would have cut that mother. He would have cut him down if he turned. Qui-Gon does not play. He did lose to, well, we'll see next part. Qui-Gon's notorious for being the only guy to die to a stab wound. At least currently, like, under this whole Disney canon. Oh yeah, but I totally forgot. The whole point of this level is because we're freeing the Naboo pilots, so that way they can go up. I cannot get up there for the life of me. I'm so sorry. We're freeing the Naboo pilots so they can go up to the Trade Federation control ship and turn off all these dumb battle droids. There was a mini kit up there, but I wasn't able to grab it, so we skipped it. Yeah, and then once we you know, free the pilots, they're gonna go fly up to the control ship, blow it up, turn off the battle droids, which will make it easier for them to get this Viceroy to sign this treaty. And then they were actually supposed to put a level in for you know, that moment in the movie, the space battle, but it got cut for whatever reason. A few levels got cut in this game. That's, I think, one level for each story got cut. One in Phantom Menace. There was two levels that got cut from Attack of the Clones. That's crazy. Anyway, there's a few levels that got cut. I'll try to point them all out. So, yeah. I'm not sure if Anakin's flight would have taken place after this level or after the Maul fight. It kind of makes sense in either order, in my opinion. So, yeah. But now we got all the pilots. We just got to go open up the hangar doors, and then we're good. Even though I think we'll see that the hangar doors might already be open. Oh, no, it's not. Good detail. It's closed. But yeah, that's the part. Like I said, sorry about, you know, taking forever. We'll be on it. Next part will be live commentary. We're going to finish up this game and we're going to finish up Sonic. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. See you next part. Bam, bam.